Thing. Maurice Joseph breaks the seal on this one, gives Vermont the lead. And Jeremy Baker answers right back on the feed from Johnson.
Well, ball pressure now on James Johnson by Veer is going to get him to turn the corner, which was able to get a two-on-one inside and an easy layup for Jeremy Baker.
And a whistle away from the ball. It's going to go against Vermont.
When you get incredible ball pressure, the only thing you can do as an offensive player, someone's going to really get up into you, you've got to turn the corner and take the ball to the basket to alleviate the pressure. Well, when he did, James Johnson got in the lane, and Jeremy Baker was able to finish inside.
Ball even at two minutes in. This is Ruddy. Now Johnson steps back as the point guard. Bobcats get it into the front court, now have numbers. Baker with the jump.
Well, you like when someone presses you for the very first time that you attack and get a score. So Quinnipiac's press offense was better than Vermont's press defense that time.
Down low, now Fjeld from the foul line.
A chance to talk to Mike Lonergan last night, and he talked a little bit about Fjeld, Billy, having an opportunity to be a special player from 8 or 9 feet. Because Blakely's going to get double teamed, and there's a lot of open shots up there for the field kid.
Baker kicks it, now Feldine for three. Garvey Young on the run for the Catamounts and gives it right to Feldine. He was in the air, had nowhere he was going. Now Feldine runs it back the other way. Basket is good and a foul. I'll tell you what, one guy was going to call it one way. I think the other was going to call it the other, but the basket counts, and Feldine will try to make it a three-point play. Maurice Joseph commits the foul. There's Feldine. Did he move? Good call.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it's now time for...
This is a small business. It's where most jobs are created. Washington doesn't really understand that. They rushed through an $800 billion stimulus package. But instead of giving the money to small businesses that create jobs, they gave the money to government agencies. Do government agencies create jobs? You know the answer to that one. I'm Linda McMahon. I approve this message because it's time to cut spending, stop raising taxes, and put Connecticut back to work.
Healthcare alert. Daily registration limits set for all uninsured Americans. Announcing a national healthcare discount program. Everyone is accepted. According to the New York Times, no insurance leads to poor health. Don't put your health at risk. Register now for this national healthcare plan. Call for details and don't delay. Only 650 daily registrations accepted.
Call 800-973-4914 now. That's 800-973-4914.
Quinnipiac and Vermont all even as we play here early in the game. Quinnipiac, as we mentioned, playing a lot of
level. Today's game is very even, and I think this is one, obviously, that probably will play out in that same fashion.
Feldine trying to complete a three-point play here.
Well, you see their leading scorers in New England, and you talk about the evolution of the player in James Feldine. He's a kid 3 years ago, Billy, that played six total minutes for Quinnipiac, and a little more as a sophomore, and then last year had a breakout year in the senior. He's just a bona fide player.
Feldine comes out, and Deontay Twyman into the lineup for the Bobcats. Bobcats by one. It was Maurice Joseph. Moves, dumps it down low, and throws it out of bounds.
Now you see James Johnson on Maurice Joseph on the perimeter, and if you're Quinnipiac, you don't want Joseph to have space, because partner, when he gets space, he's really good from behind the line.
This is Twyman. He can shoot it from the outside. Twyman transferred in from Ball State. And the 5 second violation as Brendan Bald into the ball game, a freshman out of Maryland playing some tough defense.
Well, and again, you talked early on, and I mentioned the fact that Vermont will get up into you. And as Twyman has the basketball, you have to play going forward. You can't let pressure back you up, because when it backs you up, they have you and you get out of rhythm. Attack it and go to the basket.
Twyman is out, and the freshman Dave Johnson into the lineup for Quinnipiac. 7-6, the Bobcats. We're nearly 5 minutes in. Blakely looking for help. Getting a hand on it was Jackson, and coming down with it is Baker. This is Dave Johnson into the front court. Now James Johnson looks to make a move. And does. Looks like Marcus Haynes on the dribble.
But they're making it uncomfortable for Quinnipiac's ball handlers. They really are. Good wide stance, good pressure, real good job moving your feet.
This is Baker, 14 on the shot clock for the Bobcats. Now 10 on the shot clock as James Johnson has it off a pick. Back to Jackson for the short jump.
A pretty good tempo to the end of that offense for Quinnipiac. They didn't get what they want early, and then they walk it down to 10 seconds. Little pick and roll, double team, and then kick it out, and the young fella knocks one in from 8 feet.
9-6, Maurice Joseph for three. And they let it bounce out of bounds, and the Bobcats take over. Take a look at Jackson.
Pass the ball in the corner there, Billy, and you have a flat pass here. And with all the media timeouts, it's probably one Davey Johnson wants to get a timeout. Quinnipiac probably caught a break there in the fact that it wasn't a three-point play.
Feldin, two shots. Feldin, the senior out of New York City, Cardinal Hayes High School.
Feldin right now from the field, 1 for 5. One was a layup, and Maurice Joseph has done a real good job on Feldin in getting him a little playing faster off the screens. He needs to slow down a little bit. And
a couple of field goals, and really has been going after the offensive glass so far this afternoon.
I think what happens sometimes, Jeremy Baker is a construction worker. You know, he carries his lunch with him. And I think when you do that for 3 years, you get to be a senior, and I think you get caught up in, you know, what would it like to be wearing a coat and tie to work? And he decides to play from the perimeter. And then you start saying, well, you're not as productive as playing from the perimeter. It's time to put on the hard hat and let's get back inside. It's not glamorous, but so effective for you as a player and for this team. And that's what Baker's doing today, partner.
Makes one of two free throws.
Everybody's just trying to get the ball inside, and they're trying to shorten the game. It's like the North Conference when the Vikings are playing the Bears. Everybody's running the basketball.
Three-point attempt from Baker, and he hits it. First three-pointer of the game, and Baker now with 8 points for the Bobcats.
He's been a guy because he hasn't scored a lot. Tough up here. That's why they never lose.
Bobcats with the ball, game tied at 21. That's Baker again. Jeremy Baker with 10 points.
Nice job along the baseline, huh? Got a little bit of rhythm, but it started because, you know what, he went to work today. He went inside, and he's starting to get his confidence up a little.
Quiet offensively has really come out of the shell this afternoon. Bucket here, he's got 10 points for the Bobcats. And just beating the 10-second violation, they get it down. Thompson with the jump. Ruddy with the rebound.
It's a shot that Thompson has to take. He's sitting there saying, okay, you haven't played all season, but you got to take the
Ruddy corrals the rebound.
A handful of guys in his Vermont team from that Maryland, D.C. area, and that's the home of Mike Lonergan, so he's familiar with the coaches and the players.
James Feldin. There's Feldin. Feldin now with 7, Ruddy with 6. But it's Jeremy Baker leading the Bobcats with 10. And Quinnipiac with the 4-point lead and a 30-second timeout. Feldin really is the offensive spark plug on this team.
Well, you hit it right on the head. He's been the guy that's established himself as the calming effect, the Benadryl for this Quinnipiac team. He'll slow you down. But what's happened today is Vermont has Feldin playing fast, but that's why Jeremy Baker's playing well. So Baker's got to be able to get him a Christmas card saying, thank you, James, because two people are playing you, I've been able to get some time.
Take a look here. There is the miss by Thompson, but Ruddy with the offensive rebound and putback. And the other half of the daily double for Quinnipiac is Feldin with the runner.
And what you saw with Feldin, which he does a great job, he recognizes where his defender is. And that time, Joseph was behind him. And that's running numbers. When someone runs your numbers, they're behind you. You need to curl to the basket, and that's what Feldin did. Seen series now with both teams where their defense of both programs is better than the opponent's offense. And that time right there, Quinnipiac's defensive package had Vermont backing up. And we've seen Vermont do it to Quinnipiac. So it's been very well played, well coached teams with a lot of